Hi, my name is Dwitya Mukhopadhyay. I have completed my BTech in Electrical Engineering from Sardar Patel College of Engineering. I'm a fresher and I'm currently studying in Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies. Hi. So I always wanted to be at that hierarchy of an organization where I could take major decisions by myself. Like, I would have that decision-making capability. So I wanted that from the very beginning of my career, rather than having a work ex initially and then doing an MBA. That's why I decided to take up MBA immediately after my graduation. So I always had interest in pursuing an MBA in finance, and we are aware about the fact that JB is one of the best institutes for doing an MBA in finance. So I had only JB in mind as my target. And if not this year, I had decided to take up my placement and try again next year. But JB was my only target. So the study material provided by T.I.M.E. covers extensively each and every topic which comes in the MBA CET exam. And every topic has every type of questions you can ever imagine. Like, so I had begun my preparation in around December when I had my Christmas vacations. So I had made a timetable as to, like, there is the A section and the B section of every chapter. So I had decided that one section of each chapter I will definitely finish. Like, I had planned every day, like, one exercise of one topic I would do each day from each of the sections, like quants, DILR, logical reasoning, verbal. And it really helps because I had maintained a notebook and where I had solved each and every problem, and I had marked the questions which I found difficult. Like, I would also approach the faculty members in case I faced some difficulty in solving any of the questions. And it's basically, if you just manage to solve one exercise of each and every topic, you are able to go through every type of problems that come during the exams, like in the over the years, the exam questions which have come. So I made sure I utilized the whichever amount of time I could get, I could utilize it more efficiently. Like, I was in my final year of engineering, so I made sure, like, the lectures which are not as important, where I knew I didn't have to pay as much attention, I would sit on the last bench of my class and I would use the materials to solve problems during that time. Then I would I would usually use that time for DILR or quants. And the material for verbal, like the cue cards or something like parajumbles, which does not require like a lot of usage of the hand, I would read those materials during like having my lunch or having my dinner. That's how I would utilize my time. So I began my preparation around end of December, beginning of January. So what I had started with was the study material. I used to religiously try to solve each and every type of problem given in the study material. And while solving the study material, you tend to do it at your own pace. So every time I would do one chapter, I would make sure I would go back home and I would do the sectional test of that particular topic. So that's how I did. And simultaneously, while this was going on, I started giving the AIMCETs that had started. Every weekend it would happen. And in the beginning, the few AIMCETs that I gave, I had not decided any strategy. What my strategy was, the first 3-4 AIMCETs, I will use it to analyze and strategize what my strategy should be. Because I used to think my quant is strong, and I also knew my analytical reasoning was also strong. So I had to decide which area should I start with during my actual CET exam. So the first CET, what I did was I did the first I did quant, then analytical, then abstract, then verbal. Verbal is not as strong as the other areas, so I always left it for the last. And it doesn't take as much as time, so that's why I kept the last 20 to 25 minutes for verbal. So it was only the first section which I had to decide on. So first when I did quants, and then later when I started with analytical reasoning, I realized there was a lot of difference, because analytical reasoning, the questions are almost 75 marks. So I decided that I will start with that, and then I would go exactly in the order in which the CET exam is, like the analytical, abstract, quants, and then verbal. So that in the end, the remaining AIMCETs, I would follow this order. So beginning, I would give the AIMCETs every week, and as the time progressed towards the actual exam, I would start giving the SAMCETs as well. Like, I would increase the frequency of giving the mocks every week. Like, first it was just once a week, and then I would increase to twice to thrice a week as the actual exam progressed. But the most important part is to analyze your exam. Like, after you give the mock CETs, you have to make sure that you go through where you have gone wrong, like which area are you weak in, so that you can get back to that area in the study material, or you could do the sectional test of that area. So analysis is extremely important, and I would make sure that one day I would keep for analyzing an entire mock. So that was my strategy basically. So CET is a very speed bound test, so you have to make sure that you're able to solve 200 questions in 150 minutes. So you need to practice a lot. So my advice for you would be to aim high and stay focused. And if you have joint time, then you have nothing to worry about. The faculty members have put in all their efforts to make sure that you are able to achieve your goal, and keep giving the AIMCETs, or keep practicing more and more. Stay focused. And on the final note, I would like to say, shoot for the moon. Even if you miss it, you will end up among the stars. All the best.